Welcome to this ASP.NET Core Scheduler Control Tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to add appointments from multiple resources to the Syncfusion ASP.NET Core Scheduler. Look at this scheduler. It displays various appointments in different colors. Each of these colors represents a specific person for whom the appointment is scheduled. A resource can be anything, like a person's task or an object that exhibits action over time. I will demonstrate how to define resource data for the scheduler, add appointments of multiple resources to the same scheduler layout, and differentiate between appointments by their color. First, I open my existing ASP.NET Core application where I've added the basic properties to render the scheduler. To learn more about integrating the scheduler control into an ASP.NET Core web application, please check the Getting Started video linked in the card above and the description below. Let me run this application by pressing the F5 key. See, the scheduler control is rendered with the provided appointments. Now I am going to show you how to assign the resource to the scheduler events. First, I add the schedule resources tag to provide the one or more resource details. Now, I plan to add a single resource by adding one eSchedule resource tag. After the resource is added, I need to define resource data. I navigate to the controller page. Add a Mata class named resource data. And include the fields owner text, owner ID, and color. Then I navigate to the index page. Add the list variable, resource details, and define the details for each resource. To map these resource details to the scheduler data source, I navigate to the controller page and add a resource ID field to the appointment data model class. Let me define a resource ID field with an appropriate value to each list item. Now I assign this resource data source to the data source property. So far, I have defined the resource data and bound it to the scheduler. Now I need to map the resource fields to the scheduler. There are more built-in fields to assign the resource to the scheduler appointments, and I will show a few basic fields now. I add the field in the eSchedule resource tag. And map it to the resource ID field of appointment data. This value indicates that the owner ID field will be mapped from the event data source. Here I have provided the resource ID value, which means that this appointment belongs to the resource whose owner ID is 1. So this appointment belongs to the resource John, as his ID matches the value 1. Next, I add the title field to set a label for the resources field on the editor window and set the value resources. Next, moving on to three important fields, text, ID, and color. These fields serve as mappers for the resource data source. To bind the resource collection, I map the field owner ID to the ID field, owner text to the text field, and color to the color field. The owner ID field is used to map the appointment data and resource data IDs. Text field is used to bind the resource's name from the resource data source. Appointments associated with different resources will be created in the scheduler and differentiated according to the resource color assigned in the resource's data source, indicating which resource each appointment belongs to. See the scheduler, appointments are color-coded for different resources. If you double-click on an appointment, an editor window opens. In this window, you'll see the resource field whose name is Robert, indicating that the appointment is scheduled for Robert. You can assign only one resource to the event at a time. If If you want to assign multiple resources for the same appointment in the eSchedule resource tag, add the allow multiple property and set it to true. When I double-click on the appointment, the editor window opens and the appointment is scheduled for Laura. I can also assign another resource, John, to this event. In this video, I showed you how to add appointments from multiple resources to the Syncfusion ASP.NET Core Scheduler. You can download a working example of this from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will get you a free license key to use our ASP.NET Core products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please like and subscribe to our channel.